Evaluate functions domain. The domain is the possible values of x, or in other words, our input. For fractions in our domains, the denominator cannot equal zero because it makes it undefined. And for even radicals, insides of the radical, talking about this part here, has to be positive. Or in other words, greater than or equal to zero. And then whenever you divide an inequality, so this is when we're finding a domain for an inequality, if you divide by a negative, you must reverse the inequality. So in other words, if you had, let's say we had negative x is greater than or equal to 2, if we divided by a negative 1 here, then this would become x is less than or equal to a negative 2. So let's take a look at our examples. In example 1, we want to find the domain. And so what we're really looking at is the stuff that's inside here. We really don't care about the other stuff. We only want the stuff that's inside. So we're going to take negative 3x minus 9. We said that it must be greater than or equal to 0 in order to be positive. So we set it greater than or equal to 0, and then we solve, just like we would a regular equation. I get negative 3x is greater than or equal to 9. Divide by a negative 3. And because we divided by a negative, our inequality is going to flip the other direction, and we're going to get x has to be less than or equal to negative 3. That is our domain. In example 2, we have an absolute value here. And remember when we were looking at our domains, we had fractions and we had even radicals. There's nothing there about absolute values. So that means this is really easy. That x can be all real numbers. There's no restrictions there. It can be anything. And so that's what we say. Now let's go down to example 3. In example 3, we said that in fractions, we cannot have 0 in the denominator. So that means we're talking about this part right here. We need to know what would cause that to be 0. So we're going to solve this. We're going to say that x squared minus x minus 2 equals 0. And if you remember, how do we solve a quadratic? We were going to factor that. So I put in my two sets of parentheses for me, and only one way of factoring x, only one way of factoring 2. Let's see here. We're going to be subtracting, so that's a negative 2x plus x. I wanted to be a negative x. Or however you arrive at that, maybe you are doing the AC method. Okay, so that means I've got x plus 1 equal to 0 and x minus 2 equal to 0. If we solve those, we're going to get x equal to negative 1 and x equal to 2. So what that means for our domain then is that x cannot equal negative 1 or 2. That's our domain.